We've come for another one of our spring walks again, but nesting.
Lying this path leading to the top of the wood.
Aye, because we did find
the... Yeah.
We found a few.
Streets of terrace juices.
Aye, just, that's what all the wilds for.
Probably 60 or 70 years ago, maybe it's more, I don't know.
Uh-huh, it was a long time gone.
It'd probably more than that, wouldn't it?
Aye. But we did find a few nests along here. We often see bits in the hedges, and there's a Ditlar's nest up on the water, and the grey wagtails in the nut patch.
Look for it.
Aye, just to see how they're going. But we've got people walking behind us while turning the camera off until they get past. Well, we're here in the wood. We've just came down that path there.
Top of the woods, we're just looking at this waterfall, because the last couple of years we've found the dippers and the wagtails in there.
Aye.
Last year we found the wagtail but need dippers, but the year before we found the dippers and the wagtail.
Aye. Well, the wagtail was under the tree and the dipper was next to the waterfall, Paul. So we're going to have a walk up it and see if we can spot out. I'll leave the camera on just in case old flies out, because there's a load of times we've been walking into things and stuff's flew out and I haven't had the camera turned on. I'm keep looking around at the same time because you get a lot of people walking through this area. I don't want to think I'm filming it. Right, so I'm going to look up here. I can see where the old wagtail was, just under there. Well, one of the old ones, anyways. I haven't seen them doing the other part of the river either. Where we normally see them every year. That was the old nest. We've done that lot. Yeah, I'm just looking under here to see the bit that could be hanging under here. We haven't found any new ones, but, well, here and that, I think that's one under there. I'm just not sure what it is. I'm going to have to get up on the top and have a look in from this top. Must be getting short, isn't it? It is an old grey wagtail there. I'm looking in for the dippers, because there's nearly always a dippers in here. Somewhere. The old ones are there. Can't see a new one in yet. God, I'm getting off here, I'm just sore. Wrench. That was nice, yeah. Yep, back here. Back over here. Could be hiding anywhere. Having a close look around and see if I can see anything. To hide them in that little place. Well, we've had a good look at doing in the run there, couldn't find anything. Well, we're gonna head back up to a couple of other different places, see if we can find anything fresh. We've just done our way back out, but there's a it's what it looks.
Quite night when I've really seen.
Seen nothing in the water there.
Didn't see out in the water. Didn't even see the birds, did we?
No, there was no wagtail, no dipper.
A bit crap.
But just in there, that looks like a blackbird's nest. Given if it's older on building, but it's too far into the back of there, we'd never get into that one. It's trouble in this hedge, it's an old thick hedge. We're gonna walk down and have a good look down, because it's. Gone's doing quite far. Baby rabbit.
It's away.
That little wren's still there, like, in the grass.
That's bobbing the run,
it's still there. We're just bobbing all the way through the little. See that thing run? They just sit there. That's what I'm working in for now, to see if I can... Oh, there's the wren flies. Just to see if I can see any little rabbits sitting. The ones that are flat. There's quite a few. We've come away from the river. We're trying somewhere else. We've got... There's a small bush there. Well, thorn. Pheasants over the back there, but yeah, it's been kind of quiet. But there's a lure magpies, it's only about 8 foot off the ground.
Have you ever seen that last year?
No, I definitely didn't see it last year. I'm gonna have a look, get a close up. They're a good nest, magpies. Get in, mate.
That would be for Kim up there, wouldn't it? I don't know how easy the scaling had.
Yeah, I know, mate. I had to give it a bit of a rattle or something like.
Long thrush here. Are you getting every shot?
Aye, that's.
Sitting in the sun.
It's shaking around a little bit, like I'll have to stabilise it.
Yeah, it's fine, isn't it? Mm. The length of time it's sitting, you could have probably had that on this stand and got it, couldn't you?
I don't know. It would look much better on the stand.
The song push, in song.
Uh-huh, it's just hoping the rain doesn't spoil it too much.
Yeah, I'm a bit wet on the lens, I guess.
It's went quiet a bit.
Yeah, it's off again.
Okay, a little rain's just blowing there under
the ceiling, just below.
Uh-huh.
Certainly quite a way.
Just put the camera back on, we're under some old bridge, it's disused.
It's close where we filmed the Kestrel earlier.
Earlier on in the year, the Kestrel was just up there in them trees.
But a month ago.
Aye, but a month ago, we've got them in the earlier videos. But
just below where this hole is, it's all this. Ali's dropping to
you. Aye, there's the hole up there. Down here.
This end bit
of Kestrels are notorious for this, right?
Kestrel? Do they have pellets of Kestrels? Or do they?
There's two different pellets there, right? Ah, your pellets.
Yeah. I'm wondering that.
Oh, there's another pellet. There's a few pellets.
Yeah.
Quite a few.
So.
Well, there's quite a few of them. And all that dropping looks fresh because the rain gets into here and would have washed it away. We didn't see that last year. And you can see under there, in that little corner, that's where it will be. There's a bit of a old nest in the top corner one. Hard to see from here, right? I'll zoom in on it a little bit, because you cannot see it when you're under it. But when I get back and put it on the computer, I might be able to see something in there. I think I've got a bit of water on my lens, because it was raining a few minutes ago, and I'm going to wipe it off. So what plan is, well now we've got possible, it's a Kestrel, definitely going to be a Kestrel, but there's another one up there now. This one looks like the one that gets used more than anything. So we're going to get the camera on top of the tripod and get a stick tied. Well, I've got a roll of sellotape here for emergencies. We're going to get a longer stick, sellotape at the bottom of the tripod with a stick, camera on the top and lift it up. It's about 15 foot, so we're going to need a stick that's at least 8 or 10 foot. Just so I can get it up into there. And what we'll do at the same time, we'll check out the other ones, because there's that corner and there's the other two corners where I've got little bits of like platforms, as if there were nests. I'm not sure which one's going to be getting used. I want to try and get it past the wall, right? Isn't it? might have had the camera now in front of the night. Like more straight like that.
Just try and like push it reading high as you can then rest the stand on the wild there.
Aye.
I lost it.
It's a bit awkward, isn't it? Once you get the eye. You've got to go higher than you can.
Yeah, that's hitting the roof, isn't it?
Yeah, aye. Come doing up that one. That.
Do you want to do this one? Or is it?
I do that one first.
There's not much of a gap there, is
it? I know. That's going to roll with that one. You might have to twist away on that. This one looks just as good as the other ones. Well, we've just walked back up from the bridge where we were to check the magpies. Well, we'll check the magpies and the where the bridge was, where the kestrels was. Looks like a kestrel nest site. Aye. Go up, man. 1.1 yet. Aye, we've seen them, we've got some good shots of them in these trees. Just a few weeks ago, we've got them on. There's a pair of them. But we're back to the car, and it's been raining a canny bit, so I'm wet. The camera's wet, everything. So, without we're putting on, we'll put that on. Right, obviously, you'll be watching it.